Hello friends, today we are going to learn some important aspects of fatty liver. As you all know, fat is one of the most important metabolic organ in the human body, and it is also one of the largest organ of the body. When fat fails because of any particular disease, all the metabolic activities of the body stops. So the person enter into coma state. So fat is mainly meant for metabolic activities. There is only very small amount of fat is stored in the body, that is less than 1 to 5% of the total weight of the liver. Excessive accumulation of the fat in the liver is called as fatty liver. And this accumulation of the fat impairs all the functions of the liver. There are two important conditions which leads to fatty liver. That is, the first one is, it is because of excessive production of triacylglycerol or fat. The second important type of fatty liver, where there is decreased mobilization of the fat from the liver, and that also causes deposition of fat within the liver. Normally, the adipose tissue is the major organ for the storage of fat, but in these two conditions, there is accumulation of fat takes place within the liver. So, the type 1 fatty liver, where the fat gets accumulated in the liver because of the increased free fatty acid level in the blood. Normally, the fatty acid level in the blood is not increased in a healthy individual, but in conditions like prolonged starvation and a diabetes mellitus, where the hormone sensitive lipase, it is the enzyme which normally brings about lipolysis, in a healthy individual this enzyme gets inactivated, but in conditions like prolonged starvation, where there is an absence of carbohydrates, and in case of the severe diabetes mellitus, where there is a decrease, even though there is increased glucose which cannot be metabolized due to lack of insulin, automatically activates the enzyme hormone sensitive lipase. So in such condition, there is increased lipolysis occurs, which increases the concentration of fatty acids in the blood. So these increased fatty acids are finally the transported into liver, and the increase in the concentration of fatty acids in the liver that causes its conversion into fat. So because of these increased plasma free fatty acids, which is sent into liver, and that fatty acids are converted into triacylglycerol, and that increases the concentration of fat within the liver. But under normal circumstances, only a limited amount of VLDL is produced from the liver. So this VLDL is not sufficient enough to transport all the fat from the liver into the adipose tissue. So that leads to deposition of fat within the liver, causing fatty liver. The second type of fatty liver, decreased mobilization of fat from the liver takes place. As I told in the earlier slide, I have explained the VLDL is required for the transport of fat from the liver. But in the second type of fatty liver, there is decreased production of VLDL takes place because of various reasons. The major reason behind the production or decreased production of VLDL is there is a decreased synthesis of apoprotein, that is apoprotein B100, which is required for the synthesis of VLDL. That decreases the synthesis of VLDL. So decreased production of this VLDL leads to inability of the liver to transport the fat which is normally produced within the liver. So accumulation of fat takes place in the liver, causing a fatty liver. So the important causes here for a deficiency of VLDL, because of decreased apoprotein synthesis, and also there are various other factors which are responsible for the decreased production of VLDL is the absence of lipotropic factors. What are lipotropic factors? The lipotropic factors are those factors which increases the production of VLDL and thereby those prevents the fatty liver. So they are important factors to name them. So lipotropic factors are betaine, choline, methionine, vitamins, cobalamin, folic acid, essential fatty acids, and some important amino acids like serine, glycine, antioxidant like vitamin C and vitamin E, and the mineral ion called selenium. Here, the lipotropic factors like choline, betaine, and methionine, all the three are very, very essential for the synthesis of phospholipid called lecithin. Lecithin is one of the major phospholipid present in the outer covering of the VLDL. So, a deficiency of these lipotropic factors like choline, betaine, and methionine decreases the synthesis of VLDL. And essential fatty acids, it is also very important for the synthesis of various phospholipids. Each and every phospholipid, it contains a second fatty acid bound to that is an essential fatty acid. So, a deficiency of essential fatty acid is also decreases the VLDL synthesis. Then vitamins, cobalamin and folic acid, both are required for the synthesis of choline, betaine and methionine, and these lipotropic factors, as I mentioned earlier, they are required for VLDL synthesis. And antioxidants, vitamin C and E, and the most important antioxidant mineral called selenium, all the three are very important for the prevention of oxidation of phospholipids which are present in the VLDL. So, the deficiency of these antioxidants, the prevention of peroxidation doesn't take place and causes the oxidation of the membrane of VLDL, and thereby that increases the breakdown of VLDL. So, the quantity or the concentration of VLDL decreases and the capacity of the liver to transport the fatty acids or the fat from the liver to extrahepatic tissues decreases, and that leads to fatty liver. How to manage fatty liver? So, as I said, in type 1, there are two important conditions which leads to fatty liver, that is prolonged starvation and uncontrolled diabetes mellitus. Prolonged starvation can be managed. So, in prolonged starvation, the fatty liver can be prevented by feeding a proper balanced diet for the individual. A balanced diet is nothing but which contains a sufficient amount of carbohydrates, a sufficient amount of proteins and fat. They should be present almost in 6:2:2 ratio. And deficiency of carbohydrate, that increases the utilization of fat present in the liver, and that causes increased lipolysis, which may increase the fatty acid level in the blood. That may lead to fatty liver. So, by giving a proper balanced diet, a fatty liver which could be caused by the starvation can be prevented. And in case of diabetes mellitus, this is also very well managed by giving a proper management of glucose level. As we know, the defect in diabetes mellitus is the deficiency of insulin hormone. So, by managing the insulin level in case of severe diabetes mellitus, we can maintain the glucose level of the blood so that even though the patient is suffering from diabetes mellitus, by giving insulin injections, the glucose level can be managed so that the body can utilize glucose instead of excessive lipolysis from the extrahepatic tissues. So, by giving a proper insulin injections, glucose level is maintained. So, that prevents lipolysis by inhibiting the enzyme called hormone sensitive lipase. So, inhibition of this hormone, that prevents lipolysis. So, the fat which is present in the adipose tissue is not broken down, and there is no chance for increase in the fatty acid level of the blood. So in both these conditions, in first condition type 1 fatty liver, by managing diabetes mellitus and prolonged starvation we can prevent fatty liver. But in case of type 2 fatty liver, if it is inherited deficiency of VLDL, it is management is very difficult. But if it is acquired deficiency of any apoproteins which are required for VLDL, like a deficiency of lipotropic factors like essential fatty acids, the vitamins, the antioxidants, that can be, by providing those lipotropic factors, we can very well manage the fatty liver. So fat is very important, and liver is also one of the most important metabolic organ. So normal metabolism of the fat can be done by giving a management of diabetes mellitus and starvation, and also by providing sufficient amount of these essential lipotropic factors, we can very well manage fatty liver. Thank you.